Hello everyone, my name is Manveer Kaur and today I am going to present a topic about avionics embedded systems. This is my brief intro. I am working as the aviation manager with Aircruise Aviation Private Limited. You can visit this website by clicking on www.aircruiseaviation.com. Further, there is my introduction as well as my bio on the given links. You can connect to this link and have a brief introduction of my bio. So let's get started with today's topic. That is all about avionics. So what is avionics basically? Avionics is the combination of aviation and electronics. Avionic systems or avionic subsystems depends on the electronics. So in avionics industry, a major multi-billion dollar industry is worldwide. So the avionics equipment on a modern military or in civil aircraft account for around 30% of the total cost of the aircraft, 40% in the case of maritime patrol or anti-submarine aircraft or helicopter, and also over 75% of the total cost in the case of an airborne early warning aircraft. So that is how an avionics system is important in an aircraft. So why is it essential? Avionics system is essential because to enable the flight crew to carry out the aircraft mission safely and efficiently, as well as mission is carrying passenger to their destination, that is civil airliner. Other than that, it is intercepting a hostile aircraft, attacking a ground target, reconnaissance, or maritime patrol that is used for the military aircraft. So what are the mandatory equipments in civil airlines? So the first one is ATC, that is aircraft to prevent the collision. Then next come is GPWS, that is aircraft immediate danger to flying to ground. The next is TCAS, that is for avoid mid-air collision. So here in this photograph, it is a brief description. So all these are the avionics components which are being used in the aircraft. So first one we will be heading towards with the displays. So the first is cockpit display. So the cockpit display basically provides a visual presentation of information and data from the aircraft sensors and systems. It also provides pilot with primary flight control information, navigation information, engine data, airframe data, as well as the warning information. So here in this picture, you can see a cockpit. So all the electronics which is being embedded into a cockpit, these are basically dependent on the avionics. And here are the different instruments which are used for the different purposes. So this cockpit is a cockpit of a civil aircraft. If we talk about a military aircraft, so military pilot also has wide array of additional information view, such as infrared imaging sensors, radar, technical mission data, weapon aiming, as well as threat warning. So in this visual, you can see a cockpit. So this is a military aircraft cockpit, and this is how a cockpit of military aircraft look like. Further then, we will be talking about multifunction display. So a large format display to the pilot for making safe decision on every phase of the flight. So MFD shows navigational information from the multiple systems. MFD also displays weather information from multiple systems, onboard radar or lightning detection system sensors. The MFD can change the color or shape of the data to alert the aircrew to hazardous situation. So here we can see some screens in the cockpit. So this screen is basically a multifunction display. So in a multifunction display, it is a combination of different aircraft instruments which are presented into a single screen. There are six basic aircraft instruments, and these six different instruments are incorporated into a single screen. Apart from that, here in the center visual, we can see a screen which is basically used for navigation and the weather forecast purpose. So in this screen, we can have a clear data about the navigation as well as the weather report. After the display, we will head towards the communication system. So if we talk about communications, there is a two-way communication between the ground bases and the aircraft, or between the aircraft is essential for ATC, that is air traffic controller. Communication radio suite on modern aircraft is a very comprehensive and covers several operating frequency bands. So the long range is HF radios operating in the band of 2 to 30 megahertz, and near to medium range, that is for civil aircraft, by VHF radios operating in the band of 30 to 100 megahertz. So in this picture, we can see how a pilot is using a headphone as well as a mic set to have a two-way communication with an air traffic controller. So after the communication, we will talk about the data entry as well as the control. So data entry and control is essential for the crew to interact with avionic systems. Such system ranges from keyboards, touch panels, direct voice input, speech recognition, as well as the technology. Next to that, we have an air data system. So the aircraft safe center system, sensor system. So in this air data system, accurate information on the air data quantities. So this system basically gives the accurate information, that is the altitude of the aircraft, the calibrated speed, the vertical speed, the true airspeed, the Mach number of the flight, the airstream incidence angle, that is also known as angle of attack, as well as the total air temperature. So these are the various units which are covered by the air data systems. Next to that, we will talk about the inertial sensors. So what is basically inertial sensor system? This attitude and the heading information are essential for aircraft missions. That is the autopilot system in an aircraft, the navigation system, as well as the weapon aiming, which is generally used in the military aircraft. Incorporated with it, we have inertial sensors, that is the gyros, accelerometers, HSRS, HRS, as well as the strap down. Now we will talk about the radio navigation systems. So navigation system. Accurate navigation system is important. So aircraft position, ground speed, direction of flight is essential for the aircraft's mission, whether it is a civil or a military aircraft. So navigation is basically the art of directing the movement of aircraft from one point to the another point along the desired path. So there are basically two different types of navigation. So first one is navigation by dead reckoning, and next is the radio navigation, or it is also called as position fixing navigation system. Next to that, we will talk about radar. So radar systems, which is basically used for weather radar also, it is installed in all civil airlines and in many general aviation aircraft, which is used to detect water droplets and provide warnings of storms, clouds, turbulence, etc. It should be noted that in severe turbulence, the violence of the vertical gust can subject the aircraft structure to very high loads and stress. So this is a picture which describes how a radar system works actually. So here we can see an aircraft connected to a satellite. So here, through the green arrow, we can see the direct communication between two different aircrafts, and the signals are coming from this satellites, which is shown in the red arrow. So this is the GPS, which is sending the position of the aircraft. So the aircraft directly communicate according to their position, their speed, and the altitude data with each other. Then next to that, here in the dotted arrows, that is in pink color, all the data gets transmitted to the ground unit for decoding. The data comes here and decoding is done. Then that data is then sent to the air traffic controller and displayed on a radar scope. So through this black dotted arrow, we can see a picture. So this is basically a screen where the positioning of the different aircrafts can be seen over here. So once the data is decoded, then the information is further sent to the air traffic controller screen, through which the air traffic controller can detect the position of the various aircraft. So next we will talk about the infrared sensor systems. The infrared sensor systems have the major advantage of being entirely passive systems. The infrared sensor systems can be used to provide a video picture of the thermal image seen of the outside world, either using a fixed FLIR sensor or alternative a gimbal IR imaging sensor. So after this avionics, we also have some tasks on automation. So first comes is housekeeping management. So housekeeping management is another important factor. The term housekeeping management has been used to cover the automation of the background tasks, which are essential for the aircraft's safe and efficient operation. Such tasks include fuel management, that is the embraces fuel flow and fuel quantity measurement, and control of fuel transfer from the appropriate fuel tanks to minimize changes the aircraft trim. The next task is the electrical power supply system management. Then it comes as cockpit or cabin pressurization system, the environmental control system, warning systems, as well as the maintenance and monitoring systems. So these comprise monitoring and recording systems, which are integrated into onboard maintenance computer systems. So this provides the information to enable speedy diagnosis and rectification of equipment and system failures by pinpointing faulty units. So after the housekeeping management, another task is engine control and management. So it is used to control and the efficient management and monitoring of the engines, especially. Electronic equipment involved in a modern jet engine is very considerable. It forms an integral part of the engine and is essential for its operation. So that was all about the avionics embedded system. So this is my bio. You can connect me on the social media also. So this is a book which is written by the Captain Shekhar Gupta, that is Pilot's Career Guide. You can buy this book from the Amazon. That was all about my today's presentation. Thank you for watching it.